Ali, I first spoke to you about nearly three years ago, about making your professional debut. And 3 years later, here we are, we're talking about it again, but this time, September the 15th, it's a definite.
I'm making my debut now. Been a long time coming.
Yeah, mate. Do you know something? I take my hat off to you, mate, because that's a long, long time for you to continue in a sport that basically shut its door on you.
Do you know what? Boxing, it was put to an end, do you know, back in 2015. 2016 really.
Well, actually, you were going to turn pro in 2015. I didn't speak to you then, it was the year afterwards I spoke to you. But you just beat a VIP fighter, amateur fighter, Johnny Brown. And then you didn't make the weight for the final, did you?
Yeah.
And that's when you decided to turn over, am I right?
Yeah.
And that's when you got the nod that wasn't going to be possible?
2 weeks prior to the fight, I was going from the last sparring session and Steve rang me and he said, "Are you diabetic?" And I said, yeah, I'm diabetic. And he said, "Well, they're not letting you box. We're going to put it on hold, you know, for this at this moment in time for you not to box." And I was heartbroken, honestly. I was like in the shape of my life. You was in the gym, you saw me, I was in some tremendous shape. And that was it. Boxing was put to sleep for me, for about a week.
Well,
then I went back into the amateurs.
I was going to say, so the professional door was closed and that was never going to open for you.
Yeah.
But you went back in the amateurs.
Yeah.
I've seen you get to the Northwest Regional Final. Where you lost a very close decision to a kid who's doing well in the pros now.
I thought I won the fight, to be honest with you.
I videoed it and your face, you were...
Split decision goes to the blue corner.
You were expecting to win and you were very, very upset when you didn't.
95% of the people in the crowd even thought I won the fight. But let's put that behind me now, and September 15th, new chapter.
Where I was trying to go there with that was the fact that when you know, every amateur boxer's dream is to eventually turn professional.
Yeah.
And that door had already been shut on you, and yet you still went back into the sport. I think it must prove how much you...
Do you know, I'm passionate about boxing, Lee. Do you know, like, if you come to my house, you'll only see, do you know, boxing videos on, do you know, if you watch telly. Do you know, from being a schoolboy, do you remember Friday Fight Night?
Yeah.
When that used to come on Friday, now it's Saturday Fight Night. But I've been watching boxing, do you know, forever. Remember staying up for Ricky Hatton versus Costa Zoo, do you know, 2 o'clock in the morning, because they have to change it to the Australian time. Boxing is my life. So the amateurs, when I put that to an end, I ended up in America, do you know, to watch...
Yeah, you did. Tank. I've seen the photos. You were with everyone over there.
I met Tyson, Andre Ward, Roberto Duran. I met everybody, Adrian Broner. I met them all out there. Vasyl Lomachenko, watched him train. I got to do pads with Freddie Roach. Went to Wildcard Gym, went to Johnny Tocco's gym, went to Robert Gassi's academy where I watched Vasyl Lomachenko train. Honestly, it just gave me a pump within my body.
But you know, maybe so, but was that not a little bit of torture? Because you're mixing with the people that you wanted to be.
Yeah.
And knew that could no longer be, if you know what I mean. So really, you know, was that not a little bit...
I always think positively. I live the life. I don't party. I don't take drugs. I stay healthy. I try eating clean as well, like drinking water as well. I knew, do you know, somewhere, do you know, in the back of my head that eventually I will get my license.
Well, so time went on. I think when did this journey start with the legal proceedings? Because it's a friend of family, a friend of yours, who said, "Look, we got to do something about this."
I said, "Shameen, yeah." Do you know, I've got to say, do you know, that man, he's keep me so motivated. Do you know, like, for example, we speak every night. Do you know, like, when this camera goes down, he'll probably ring me and ask me, do you know, how's training got on? You know, if I say, "Oh, I didn't feel too good today," I'll say, "Look, you have a bad day, you know, pick it up tomorrow again." And that man, he stayed behind me, you know. We did a peaceful protest at the Joshua Parker fight.
Yeah, you went down to
Cardiff.
Yeah, that was
outside the Principality Stadium. 10 of us left from Rochdale, and this is no word of a lie, there must have been 10 to 15,000 people joining me, you know, at the stadium. And I got to speak to Robert Smith out there as well, you know, the General Secretary of the board. And he gave me a bit of motivation as well. He said, there's light at the end of the tunnel, you will get your license.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And now that's happened.
We've now
got a fight day. I've been down here watching you prepare. It's been a strength and conditioning coach with Scott Mitchell today. Yeah. And a bit of pads with sexy Tom McNeil. How did you find this place? Because when I spoke to you last, you were up in Blackpool, or near Blackpool, at Carl Ince's gym.
Yeah, do you know, I was travelling 42 miles there, 42 miles back. For example, it took me 90 minutes to go there in the morning, then we trained for about 2 hours, and 90 minutes to get back. It was too much, mm-hmm. Do you know. I was killing myself, you know, going there, coming back. My day was, you know, ending, you know, just travelling back and forth. And, you know, I thought I'd use my brain and, you know, come home, you know, train at home. And yeah. Bolton's like a stone throw away from
Well, because actually, when Carl had his gym here in Bolton,
yeah,
you were training there as a young boy, still an amateur again.
Yeah.
What were you, 19 years old training there?
19, yeah.
And Carl had a fantastic gym at the time then, didn't he?
Yeah,
had some real quality kids.
Yeah, top gym. It was surrounded by good kids. You know, Shane Singleton, Scott Fitzgerald, Tommy Tate, Mike Stafford. The list goes on. It was a top buzzing gym, but Preston just got too much. I was travelling back and forth every day with too much.
But now you're here and you've got the similar scenario here because you've got some real good prospects coming on. Obviously Jack Flatley doing really well. You got Jack McCann who's switched from mixed martial arts and he just got his pro debut, didn't he? So, and there's a few other lads down here.
I'm rubbing shoulders a bit, you know, good kids. That ledge as well. You know, sparring good kids. I've stayed, like I said, Lee, I've had a 3 year gap, but I've never took a foot out of the gym.
No, never. Well, like I say, how many times have I bumped into you at the shows, at boxing gyms, you know, you're everywhere. Boxing seems to be.
It's my life.
When people say that, you know, actually it is yours, isn't it, mate?
Definitely, like I've been, you know, around the world, you know, travelling to watch events, I've been in America, Germany, you know, been many places, you know, to watch the boxing, even France.
Yeah.
And September 15th now, my time starts. It's my journey what starts. Let's travel the world with me now.
Well, you're 25 years old now.
Yeah.
So, you know, just a pretty good age to kick over. And I think this only can inspire you. The journey that you've had to get to this point must drive you forward.
It's made me hungry, Lee. Do you know, not having my license, I've got a point to prove, do you know, to show that why I should have my license. Do you know, why they haven't given me my license, I'm going to show, do you know, that I should have been given my license a lot earlier. So I suffered the same problem in the amateurs. I didn't get to box as a schoolboy, junior, as a youth, I didn't get to box, but as a senior, I had to box, so.
And you did well, didn't you?
Yeah,
was it 34 fights and was
28
it?
Wins.
It's not bad as a senior.
Yeah.
No junior experience or anything, no?
None of that. Thrown straight in the deep end. And now we're here, going into the pro game.
And so, I'll be silly to say that you're not excited, are you?
I'll show on the 15th how excited I am.
And obviously that's the beginning of the journey. Now, how do you find about this? Because obviously it's not cheap being a professional fighter. So do you find, have you got any sponsors or anyone that help you?
I want to say a massive thank you to David Lloyd's. They're backing me, you know, the gym.
Mm-hmm.
David Lloyd's are backing me. Aroma Thai Spa, you know, helping me recover with sports massages, Thai massages. And I've got a physio, you know, on board.
Yeah.
Thank him, Hashim.
So the journey starts September the 15th.
Yeah.
And I think it could be a very intriguing journey because, like I said, I've watched you on numerous occasions, mate, and always strong, always exciting. So good luck for the 15th, and hopefully the next time we talk, it'll be
one and only. I've got a good team. What you've got to understand is, Lee, in January, when the talks had started about my license, I was sparring Flatley.
Yeah.
I was sparring Luke Blackledge. I even sparred Amir Khan, Jack McGann, training alongside undefeated fighters, in the gym. I've been fighting since 2015 within the gyms. I was sparring Shane Singleton, having good spars with him, with other top fighters.
He was the WBC Silver International
Brian
Champion
Rose
then.
As well, sparring Brian Rose as well. Sparred, a lot of good kids. But I've never took a foot out of the gym. Let's see now, let the journey start on the 15th.
Alright, we'll leave it there. Good luck for them, mate.
Thank you, Lee. Appreciate you coming out, you know, to interview me.
Oh, it's always
a pleasure,
mate. You
spend a lot of time with the boxers as well, you know, giving us exposure. Brilliant.
No, it's always a pleasure, mate. So good luck for the 15th.
Thank you.
Take care.
Cheers. I'd like, you know, all my family, friends and people from Rochdale to come out, you know, to support me. Not only from Rochdale, but even all around England. I'd like everyone to get behind me. Make sure you come on the 15th to Victoria Warehouse. Let's have a buzzing night.